Hi everyone, and welcome to the SEO for Medium articles tutorial. My name's Andy and I'm here to help you drive more traffic to your Medium articles. So before we begin, we should probably take care of the question of what is SEO and why you should even care about it. So SEO is the process of improving the quality and quantity of traffic to your website from a search engine like Google or Bing. Now, SEO doesn't look at the paid traffic from adverts, it looks at just the unpaid side of things. This is called organic traffic. And why you care about it is because A, you're writing on Medium, and actually Medium is a really high profile website. It's probably, well, no, most recently I looked, it was number probably 200 in the world. And because of this, it's got a really high domain authority. And if you can get your article to be written really well, your SEO to do really well on that, your article will rank really well in search, just as if you can do the same on, say, Wikipedia or any other site that's got a really high domain authority, your article will rank really well. It will drive lots of organic traffic, and you then don't have to couple that with paid search as well. So therefore, you'll drive good quality traffic to your article. And if you're a member of the paid platform on Medium, you will equally be driving Medium's paid traffic through curation or through publications, and you'll be getting paid for that. Now, you may be asking, you've heard about all these ranking factors, and you can see here they've got the periodic table diagram. You've got lots of people saying there's different percentages of them, 26 of them, 12 of them. There's hundreds and hundreds of them. You can go search for Google patterns that go back to when they first set up. The reality is when it comes down to optimizing your article, we're going to focus on just a handful, because Medium takes care of the vast majority of these factors. And when it comes to taking care of them, we only care about just a few things. And in reality, it boils down to these few things of what you need to do. So the first thing is, and you can take these across all the articles you write on all sites, so you need to answer a specific question or answer a specific question or issue. It needs to be written for a specific user and not the specific audience. So what that means is that you need to write for a specific persona. So for example, if I'm writing for, say, a business owner, I write for a single business owner and not a set of business owners. If I'm writing, say, an article about NFL, I will write for a specific person who is sat on a sofa. I will answer a question specifically that they are asking. I'm not writing for a whole audience. I therefore can answer that specific question in a specific way. And it allows you to think in a more dynamic way. And it's the same with when you're answering an issue. You are directly answering perhaps a question about web development. You can sit there and you can say, actually, if this is a specific question from a specific developer, I need to say this, this, and this. And from that angle, you then move on to point three on this, which is it's got to be well researched and well written. And that comes into play in our next few slides as well, the well written part of this. But in terms of being well researched, you've got to have a passion for what you're writing about, and you've got to tell a story. So all Medium articles that do really well have something in common. It's that they've got a start, a finish, and an end. That may sound really quite basic, but when it comes to it, even if you just finished with the same thing all the time of a question, then actually it works, can work quite well. However, if you just go in there and you don't have any kind of format to your articles, and you just go, yeah, here's a piece of information. It's just not going to work on Medium. Medium is a start, finish, and an end. It's a place to tell stories. It's a place to share your experiences. It's a place to answer questions, answer issues. It's a place where long form does really well. And that's point five. You've got to write articles that are over 1,000 words to do really well on Medium. And ideally, you've got to expand and expand and expand your articles. In terms of point four, you've got to have a specific set of keywords you're really targeting. And as you'll see in what I say later, you'll have a specific keyword and you'll have two or three around it. Because having a single keyword doesn't really do too well on Medium. So in terms of your topic and keyword, you'll obviously have a target that you already want to hit as you start out. And as I've said previously, you've got to have a passion and it's got to be something you want to write about. So whether that's a passion and you're telling a story or it's something you're doing for work, it doesn't particularly matter, but you've got to do some research around it. So the tools I would suggest you use are things like Uber Suggest, SEM Rush, which is a paid tool but it's really good, and Google Trends. There's also a Google Keyword tool which looks at paid search, but it allows you to again see what kind of history is there, whether there's seasonality and stuff like that. And then from there, I'll put links in the description to those, and from there you can then build up a picture of whether there is enough search demand for it. So on the right side here you can see that I've looked for the keyword to term SEO. And each month that gets, in the UK this is, gets 40,000 hits. And that's just for a broad term. If you then hit that again on a different tool, you get a different number. So you start to build up a pitch through these different tools, which one's more reliable for a specific industry. So on Google you get a more reliable number for this term. And then once you've got your broad terms, you can then go into Medium and do some more deeper research. And by this I mean you go into articles around a similar topic and you look at them and you go, what have they asked? What have they said? How does their story flow? And then you go, okay, how many claps have they got? What are people's responses to this? What questions are they asking in their comments and responses? Can I answer their comments? And this will lead you to naturally have your main keyword and about 5 or 6 other keywords around it. That should allow you to have an article that is easily over 1,000 words. That is what you need to do on Medium, is answer people's questions. Now, a top tip here is that when you drill down into those keywords, don't just look at the headline brand, for example. Look at the abbreviations around it. So for example, Financial Times uses FT a lot. People search for FT. BP uses British Petroleum here, there and everywhere, especially if you're referring to stocks. It's one of those. You've got to be really quite clever in what you're doing and how people search for things. Don't just assume that because you search for something in a certain way, other people will. It's like in the tech industry, people assume that everyone searches the same way. People search for questions, they don't just search in 2 or 3 words. Again, do your research on this. So now let's move on to optimizing your content. So I'm going to jump out of this in a second after I've gone through these and show you how to actually do this. So optimizing your content. So the first thing is your headline. So your headline article on your article is your article title. This should be a maximum of, should include your keyword, it should be unique, and it should be no longer than 140 characters. As I say, it should always include your keyword and it should be in the first couple of words in there. Your kicker, this is your subheading, I'll show you in a second how to put this in, is something that should be really catchy and to the point. You should then, the first thing you should have on the page is a cover image. this really grabs people's attention. Without this, you are kind of done for. I've not seen a big hitting medium article without this up front. You should also make this your feature image. All images should have alt text on them. It should be descriptive of the image. You can put in keywords into this text, but you don't really need to, but it should always be descriptive of the image. You should have caption text on each image. Now, this is where I would really put keywords, because this is quite easy to do. Your article length, as we said, should be a minimum of 1,000 words, and in a 1,000 word block you should have 7 or 8 mentions of your main keyword, and you can have multiple variations of your keyword. You should use the H1s and H2s available to you in the correct format, and you should also be using bullet points and numbered lists. Now, how you do that, again, I'll show you in a second. You should also be using internal and external links. By internal links, I mean to your own articles and also to other people's articles. If you link to another person's article, go and mention them in their comments. Say, I've just mentioned you. It will win you brownie points on Medium. People love it, and it's about building community. So with that, I'm just going to jump off here and go to Medium. So here we have a blank article, which has just got my name on the top, and I'm just going to show you how to make that subheading, because everyone goes, how do I make a kicker? Now, a kicker, as I say, is just the subheading that you see. So if I just put in the test, you'll see it doesn't make a subheader. But if you scroll over it and just press this here, you'll see it makes a subtitle. Nice and easy. Then here you'd usually put your heading. Now what I'm going to do is just put in my, I'm going to copy my link to my Medium cheat sheet. Now, when you're linking to someone on Medium, you can just link to it in a normal link on the page. So test. So you can just do this. It's perfectly fine. But a better way to grab attention for a link on Medium, this is. So if you're linking internally within Medium, is to paste the link in a blank space like this and press enter. And what it'll do is, after a few seconds, it'll drop like this. Now, that grabs much more attention than any other kind of link. And it's really cool. Now, a few other things that you can do on Medium to help your SEO is, if we go back into here, so you can optimize your SEO title, your SEO description, your tags, and your custom URL. So again, we're just going to jump into here. So your tags are here. So this is on the three dots here. So your tags, these are basically your categories. Now, Medium has some main categories, and if you just do a quick Google, you'll be able to find them. There's about 70 of them. So for me, the main ones are SEO, marketing, SEO, and I play around with the others. So if I just put marketing in there, and Medium is always a good one because people search for that. Writing is another. See, 314k. And then you press it. Featured image. If you've got multiple images, you can choose from your images. Change subtitle and title. That won't change these. Importantly, that will change it on the front of Medium. And what you can do here is go to more settings. So this is a section people ignore. I'm really not sure why. So you've got settings here. So this section here, pin it to the top of your own profile and medium. These are your tags yet again. This section is your SEO title. So this is how it appears on Google. So we can call this whatever we want. This is a test. And that bar there is a pipe, and it's your shift and above your backslash on a Mac, and shift and above a backslash on the same on a Windows keyboard. And then you can put in whatever you want. So it's usually your name or your brand. So this first section is usually the title of your article, but you can put in more of that. So you can put in your something around your keyword, and then you hit save. In this section, it will usually take the first sentence or so of your, and you've got 65 characters in your title, by the way, and in your description, you then put, you've got 140 characters, so about a tweet's length, to basically do an elevator pitch. Again, use your keyword in here, so SEO for medium. Obviously, you won't do that. That is your elevator pitch, and when you search on Google, these two are the ones that come up. So this is basically your blue link, and this is the title below. And then as you scroll down, you'll see there isn't much here, you think, but actually if you click on advanced setting, you'll see customized story link, and this is your custom link. So click in there, and then you can edit this button. So SEO for media. And then you'll see it in full there. It always puts this number at the end, so don't worry about it. And the thing to always remember is this, is you always press save. Now this, you can put your full keyword in. You don't have to worry about it. As long as you've not used that keyword before, it won't kick it out because you've got your own username. Put it in, and it's got a unique number at the end of it, so it should never kick it out. And then you save it, and that's it, sorted. And you press back to editor, and that should be you optimized. So now we've, if we go back a step, so you've now optimized your header because it's got your keyword in it. You've got a subheader, you've got your featured image, you've got your alt text, your article's the correct length, you've used headings and bullet points, you've got links in your article, you've optimised your title, you've optimised your description, you've optimised your tags, and you've optimised your URL. That is all you need to do on Medium. And with that, you should be hitting the big viewers, especially if you've done your research well into your keywords and you've looked at what other people are doing on Medium. That is one of the biggest secrets on Medium, is to look at what other people are doing. So go away, initially do your own research on Medium, on Ubersuggest and SEMrush. And then go on to Medium, look at how many claps people have got, look at their comments, and answer people's questions. Put that into your own content, because that is what people are searching for. Thank you for watching. If you like what you've seen, hop onto Medium, search for me. My link's also in the description.